Greetings to everybody. So today I'll be speaking about the GTO tests, the group testing officer tests. I am assuming that repeaters obviously know what the GTO tests are. I am assuming that even the freshers have done their research and found out what these tests are, how these tests are conducted. And I would suggest only after doing a little bit of research, watch this entire video. So these GTO tests are one of the three main tests conducted in the SSB process. Three are psychology, GTO tests, and the personal interview. So these tests are usually conducted on, say, day two, three, or four. Depends board to board. Usually in the Air Force selection boards, on the first day, on the day one itself, both the screening and the psychology tests might be conducted. Then day two, three, four, would be allotted to for the GTO tests for different groups further made after the screening procedure. In the Army board, usually GTO tests are conducted on day three and four, as far as my experience goes. But it does not really matter when the tests are conducted. Your job is to be prepared. Go prepared for it. Now, So how can we prepare for the GTO tests? I would suggest it's usually better to be aware of a few things, like what GTO test is basically to test individual performance in a group, an individual's performance in a group of random people, unknown people, a group of people where a few may support him, few may not support him, few may fight amongst themselves in the group, or few may be reluctant to contribute anything in the group, or few may be extremely enthusiastic and always being forward in the group. So it is basically to test the behavior, how an individual conducts himself or herself, how he or she balances all the entire group's performances or handles the group's performances or unnatural behaviors in the group, and then ensure that as a team, everybody goes forward. So before the GTO tests, it is, I think, good to be aware of what a good team member is like and what a bad team member is like. Similarly, what and how is a good team leader? How is a bad team leader? How is a good follower and how is a bad follower? So if you're just aware of these little things, you'll know what to do, what not to do. So I personally believe that a good leader is always a good follower. I will be explaining in detail what I mean by this sentence, right? So I think it is just okay to be aware of these little things before approaching the GTO tests. So in the GTO test, I think the most important thing, the approach I use is to be my most natural self, to be comfortable with whatever I am, to not pretend to be someone else or something else. So act only according to my capabilities, my abilities, and not try to show something else. I will get to this, what I mean by this. And also, GTO test, the most important thing is it consists of, say, nine different tests. So it is very important that we listen to the instructions very carefully. That is the most important thing. That you be present during the GTO test. Be present mentally. Not just physically, but mentally as well. Listen to the GTO's instructions before any task very carefully. Be yourself and GTO tests go easy. I believe the best approach towards GTO test is to enjoy the entire process and not take it as some test or some exam or some challenge or as a competition. It is not a competition. Never take GTO tests as a competition amongst the group members, right? Your capabilities, your abilities, behavior, personality, qualities, everything is being assessed individually. But when you are in a group, even in these tests, there are a few tests where you perform in a group or you perform individually as well. So now I'll be speaking about all the different kinds of tests in the GTO process, one by one. So initially, it starts indoors. So starts with the group discussion. So usually, most of the times, two discussions are conducted. But I have been to SSBs where three discussions are conducted as well. So I'll be covering these things in detail. So once indoors, that is the first time you see the group testing officer meet him or her. So once you're indoors, they greet you and they introduce themselves to you. And yeah, that is when they give you a few instructions. They give you a few tips. The few things I mentioned, that be yourself, be natural, do not put a facade on your face or try to be something else, try to show off or something. Be your natural self, be cool, calm. And one more thing they say is follow the instructions very carefully. And other thing would be to work hard throughout all the tests. Your performance should not bother for the tests. So your performance, good or bad, should not hamper your further test. So if your initial tests are very good, it need not go to your head saying ki ab to bhai done, ab to ho gaya. That is not a good approach. Similarly, if your initial tests are not the best, you should not feel demoralized or demotivated, because then it will just hamper in a bad way your further tests, right? You won't be able to focus properly. So it is important that you be present in the present test. Give your best, analyze it. It's fine. It's good to analyze. Analyze it and then keep it aside. Then move on to the other test. Then focus with a fresh mind, with same approach, with the same kind of hard work. So I remember I used to always work hard throughout the tests, from test one to test two, or till the test nine, sorry, 9 or 10. So initially, it starts with the group discussion, like I said, indoors. So the basic instructions the GTO usually gives for the group discussion is, so y'all are supposed to discuss a few topics given by me or the GTO officer, whatever. And you're supposed to discuss as if you are a group of friends of a college, and you're discussing over a cup of a tea or a coffee in your college canteen or school canteen. Or you're sitting with your family on a dining table and you're just discussing some topic. First topic would be of choice. They will be giving two topics, out of which y'all must discuss amongst yourself in the group and choose one of the two topics. GD1 done. GD2 would be a compulsory topic given by the GTO, where the candidate will have no choice. Usually, like I said, two discussions are conducted. I'll get back to the third discussion and why it was conducted. So these are simple, very straightforward instructions. And I believe group discussion test, it is conducted first because it tells so much about an individual's behavior. It tells so many things, right? So after the group decides on one topic, so that is when entire assessment, I think, starts. So how do you all discuss amongst yourselves? Do you seek others' opinions? Okay, friends, shall we go ahead with the topic two or topic one or whatever it is? Or do you just raise your hand and say ki we will all go with topic one? Do you force yourself on others' opinions, or what do you do? I believe GD tests is a behavioral test. That is where your behavior is seen, and that tells a lot. I mean, not just the SSB, but if you go for corporate interviews or anywhere outside, this test is specifically conducted. So it tells a lot about an individual. So after the discussion commences, so it is little things are seen, ki who is initiating, right? One more thing the GTO officer mentions, that at one point, not more than two to three people should be speaking at the same time. This thing is very important to remember. Like I said, simple instructions, and all you have to do is follow these instructions, right? So after the group discussion starts, so one of y'all or you or somebody may initiate. Now, how does one initiate? So it could be key one is giving valid points, saying ki okay, so we have these three leads in the topic. So in my opinion, this is the case, and I believe this, whatever it is. So I think you can initiate when you really have a valid point to say. Do not just initiate for the sake when you're not aware of any of the three leads or what to speak or whatever it is. So do not initiate if you're not confident about speaking on a particular topic. Because there are rumors that only the ones who initiate get extra points or this, that. So in that pressure, do not go to impress the assessor or the group members and just speak something which you're not supposed to, or something very irrelevant. So even I'll tell you my approach. What I used to do is, if I was aware of the lead, I would say, okay, friends, I think out of these three leads, point B is the most effective or most relevant. And why do I feel so? Then I used to give 2 to 3 reasons. And then it was just a discussion. Then I used to ask their opinions as well. At times, there are such topics where I had no clue about what to say, what not to, what is the topic really about, or what the three leads are given. I kept quiet. So somebody or the other used to initiate. So I used to quietly listen to what is being discussed. So when you listen, when you're not aware of anything in the topic, so when you listen to your friends giving some interesting points or giving some points, then you can relate to a few things which you are aware of. Aise ho hi nahi sakta ki tumhe kuch bhi nahi pata uske baare. That you're totally unaware. Okay, even if it worst come worst situation that happens, listen to your group members very carefully. Listen to what they are discussing, whatever words they're using, phrases, sentences, examples, right? So with that, in my case, I was then able to relate ki, okay, isne ye mention kiya hai. It's a very valid point. So I can use and give this example in that case. So usually it used to happen. It happens at times that many people are discussing at the same time. Bahut 3-4 log ek hi saath bol rahe. Everyone is trying to give their own points, trying to convince their own points to the entire group and all. It has happened with me, but I have also had groups where everyone is listening to each other and all. So I'll tell you about this special group of mine. So yeah, so what did I do in such cases? Like I said, if I didn't know anything, I used to listen to everybody. Take some leads from whatever is being discussed. And then when I see that a lot of this is happening, fish market or hampering is something is happening. So I used to keep quiet in this case. Why? Unlike the screening test, in screening test, you as a group are supposed to come to a common conclusion. In group discussion, you are not supposed to come to any conclusion. You're free to discuss whatever you want. You can give as many points as you want and as many times as you want. So that is the case in group discussion. It is open. You need not come to a common conclusion. You're just there to express your thoughts, feelings, your opinions, exchange views, right? So when there was a lot of ruckus of fish market, I used to keep quiet. I used to do nothing. I used to just listen to whatever is happening. Because that I used to focus on just my performance, right? So then whenever I got a pause, 2 to 3 seconds pause, or whenever I really wanted to speak something, I used to raise my hand. I used to just raise my hand and say, friends, I just have one point. I'd like to mention this thing. And then I used to give my opinion that since one of our member or friends have mentioned this point, and they have mentioned this point, so my opinion and belief about the same is like this. And then I used to give my views or opinions. Even after this, at times it used to happen that when I am speaking after a very long time, and it is just the second time I'm speaking, I used to still get cut by the group members. And somebody and the other used to start speaking in between, trying to force their point on me and trying to convince the others. So I've seen a lot of behaviors here, right? So even when that happened, I used to just very respectfully ask, can I just finish my point and please, then you can go ahead. Then I used to say thank you and then go ahead with my point. But if nobody is giving me a chance, then I used to again raise my hand and request for a chance. Please give me a chance, right? To speak. I really want to speak about a point. Here in group discussions, it does not really matter how many times you speak or how many points you give. I believe it is a trap set by the GTO when they say you can speak as many times as you want and for however long as you want. It is a big trap, is what I believe, because it's a discussion. It's a forum open for all, and we need to listen to everybody's views and everybody's thoughts about certain topic. So if we're speaking for very long, giving many points, not letting others speak, we're speaking for 3-4 minutes straight, I think that is not a good approach. That is what I have learned, and that is what I believe. Right? So there are a lot of candidates. When in your rooms, respective rooms or barracks, or when you're just with your group, they'll be very chill, very relaxed, very calm and cool, enjoy with everybody, right? You can see a certain kind of behavior of theirs when in room. But when you reach the GTO ground, you see some other, sab aise rang bahar nikalte, aise rang khilte hai pure, aise alag alag. I've seen lots of characters. So aise hota hai ki, and it is not that they want to ensure that you don't get selected or hamper your GTO test or something like that. So it is basically that they're very desperate to get selected or very obsessed ki, I want to prove myself. I will be the one to show all my qualities and OLQs and whatnot. So that, I'll tell you, 110% goes against them. Trust me. So basically, when you spend time with your group, you actually get an idea within 2-3 days ki kaun kaisa hai kya. So even, yeah, with experience, you get an idea ki kaun kaise karega, kya karega. So in these GD especially, there are a lot of people who talk a lot, very talkative and giving unnecessary points and all. It is very important that you be very cool and calm in this, because it really hampers your psyche at times. Ki yaar chal kya raha hai, mujhe chance kyun nahi mil raha hai, ya main point hi nahi de pa raha hu, ya de pa rahi hu, whatever it is. So it is very important to be relaxed. It does not matter how many points you give and for how long you speak. All that matters is what you speak, how you speak it, quality, and do you follow the given instructions? Excuse me. That is the most important thing. So giving my examples, in lots of GDs, it has happened that I was not given a chance at all. I used to raise my hand, speak once or twice, or not speak at all. So I used to try my best by raising my hand. So, in like I said, even in these attempts, I was recommended. A few attempts, I spoke just once, twice, thrice. And out of these 4 attempts in which I was recommended. So, I was selected even then. Like I said, I just followed the instruction given and I was relaxed and cooling down. The thing that I mentioned, that at times 3 discussions might be conducted. It happened in my case. So in group discussion, so the initial 2 discussions were conducted, but I was not given a chance by my group members to speak. Whenever I raised my hand, asked for a chance, and whenever I started speaking, somebody or the other used to cut me off. So I just kept quiet and I said nothing. I utilized whenever there was a 2-3 second gap, I used to utilize it. I used to raise my hand and then I used to start speaking. I used to raise my hand only when there's a lot of people speaking at the same time. But if I see a gap, I used to get in. I used to start with my point. In this case, that is what happened. In the 2 discussions, I was not able to speak more than twice or thrice in both discussions combined. So I think the group testing officer was trying to test me specifically. It was just a group of 8 people. We were, there was only 1 GTO group. So only 8 people were screened in and we just had 1 group. So I think the GTO was trying to test whether I get pressurized. Whether now that I've not been given a chance to speak, will I now overpower others or force my points on them or be aggressive, or how does my body language change or something like that. I am sure the GTO is trying to test that, because we were given a 3rd topic. And I was the only one who had not spoken in the initial 2 topics. Same again. Same thing happened. Topic started. I did initiate in this. I spoke a few things. Then the group started and nobody was keeping quiet. So whenever I got a chance, I just raised my hand and said, "Keep, I have one point," and then I shared my point. Whenever there was a pause, I gave my point. So in this way, I think the GTO was assured that no matter how many times I'm facing this, I'll be the same. I'll follow the rules. I'll be my natural self. Here, the most important thing is we're given instructions that we are discussing with friends, discuss as if we're with friends over a cup of tea or with family on a dining table. Do we cut each other when we are on the dining table with our family? Do we cut each other when somebody else is speaking? Do we interrupt when they are speaking? Or with our friends over a cup of tea, do we interrupt them? Kisa ye to chubet, main bolunga. Ki nahi 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 nahi, ye nahi, yehi hota hai, yehi hota hai, yehi hota. So if you're normally doing these things with your family and friends, you're doing a very wrong thing, and that's not a good attitude, not a good behavior, in my opinion. But if you're normal, very friendly, very open with your friends and family in general, so get that approach to the GTO is what I would suggest. That is what is required. Do you follow the instructions, or do you get into pressure and try to prove yourself? Do you get pressurized, or are you cool and calm? That is what matters. So keep these things in mind. In normal circumstances, we may not force our points on others or cut or interrupt others. But when in GTO tests, we tend to do that, especially in the GD. Why? Because we are trying to prove ourselves. We are trying to prove ki, no, I am the best in the group. No, my points are the best. No, mere paas itne points hai, mera itna knowledge vast hai. Why? It will definitely 100% go against you. So do not do such funny things. Focus on the instructions given. See, this really hampers your initial test, also hampers your group. If they see certain kind of behavior in you that is going against the group, they might discard you in the end. They'll say, ki, yaar, ye kisi ki sunta hi nahi hai, kisi ka kuch karta hi nahi hai, khud ka hi chala raha hai. Then your further tests might get affected. They may not seek help from you, or they may not support you, or do something like that, exclude you, or do anything, right? So you're required to win your team members' hearts before you win the GTO's hearts, right? Only when you win the team members' hearts will you be able to win the GTO's heart. So that is it about the group discussion. Oh, there's one more case where three discussions were conducted. So first topic was done. Second topic was very simple. It was a social cause thing. So we finished discussing very quickly. So the GTO gave third topic. Why? Because probably he or she may want to assess one certain candidate or a few candidates again and see the discussion again. Probably they could not assess somebody's personality or behavior in the first two discussions. That happens. So regarding group discussion, keep these things in mind. Very important. These are first two tests, and they cause an image about your personality, your behavior, and everything in front of the group testing officer and your fellow candidates as well. So focus on the things I've mentioned. I believe that approach helped me get selected, recommended 4 times. Right? I'd like to give my examples as well. Initially in the GD, previous GDs where I was not recommended, what I used to do, I was of the opinion ki mujhe bahut sare points dene padenge, 2-3 points to minimum dene hi padenge. So even if I was not aware of the topic, I used to speak for the sake. Kuch bhi bolta tha, bakwas kuch point deta tha. Very irrelevant. So like I said, I used to speak for the sake. Matlab aise bas bolna hai, isliye bolna hai. That point probably was already discussed and I again mentioned it. Aur kuch aur hi discuss ho raha hai, par main pressure mein aake kuch alag hi bol raha. That happened and that went against me. Definitely that went very much against me. Because I had these rumors in mind ki nahi bolna hi padega, ye hi karna padega. I was already pressurized and desperate to get selected. So that went against me. And also there are a lot of rumors ki tumhe aise hi baithna hai. Matlab aise hi peeth seedhe karke, aise hi, and all these rumors. I didn't follow all these things in the 4 attempts. I was a relaxed chair thi jahan pe haath rakh sakte, maine haath rakhe. Comfortable discussion. Be comfortable. That's all that matters. Be comfortable while you're discussing is what I believe. And yeah, about group discussion, I think that's it. Yeah, that's it about the group discussion. So 2 to 3 group discussions might be conducted. The first test in the GTO series. Then is the group planning exercise. Again, this is an indoor test. So it's usually conducted in the same place where the GDEs were conducted. So there you're given a 3D platform or a 2D platform on which there's a certain something. So I believe y'all have done your research and know what GPE is and how it's conducted. So I'll just get to the point. Here it is very important that when the GTO is briefing about the model given, it is very important to listen to whatever they're saying about the rivers, about the most prominent color, about the roads, kacha road, pakka road, rail tapri, mountains, hills, river bodies, direction of the river bodies, towns, medical, CRPF camps, NCC camps, police stations, cities, and the... It's very important to listen to these very carefully, right? Because after briefing everything, the GTO asks, does anyone have any doubts, right? So here, if the GTO has already covered certain point and then you ask a doubt, that goes against you. Ye focus nahi tha, ye sun nahi raha tha jab main bol raha tha. So listen very carefully. But if the GTO probably has not covered a certain point, if you genuinely have some doubt, it's okay. Please ask. Does not go against you. If it's a genuine doubt, go ahead and ask. Put some common sense, have some common sense. Like if there's a plus sign, that's a hospital. So these are basic things which one must be aware of, right? So if we ask such simple things, it goes against. But if you have genuine doubt, please go ahead, ask it. Clear whatever you have. So GPE is conducted in a sequence. First, the model is explained. Then the GTO reads out the narrative. Is read, I think, once, as far as I remember. Then you're given a plain sheet of paper where you're supposed to write a solution to the given problems in the narrative, right? So lots of problems are given, 3 to 4 to 5 problems are given in the entire narrative. Now we're given 10 minutes to write a solution, right? They tell you that if the GTO group, say, consists of 8, so it is obvious that, okay, even in the narrative, there are 8 people because you are a group of certain people and then you perform the task. So how did I approach the group planning exercise? I used to listen to everything carefully. If doubt of any, I used to clear it. Now, while writing the solution, I used to write it in a certain format and that really helped me. So I'd like to share that with you all. First, I used to write the problems or the challenges and I used to write it priority wise. Now, if a pond is getting, a village pond is getting poisoned, right? So it is a threat to so many people, lots of people. So probably for me, that will be the priority one because so many lives are at stake. If, say, a girl is kidnapped, so that would be second priority. Or there's a bike accident and somebody is heavily bleeding. So I think that would be second priority, heavily bleeding one, because that needs to be attended at the current moment. Third would be the kidnapped girl. Fourth would be some farmer's goat has traveled in the forest and there are lots of tigers in the forest and all. So such situations are there. And the fifth is probably you're supposed to reach for a volleyball tournament at certain time to receive your trophy or whatever. So that is how basically the narrative is. So I used to initially write my point, my challenges priority wise, first needs to tackle this, 5 things. After that, I used to write resources available, right? Resources available in that y'all are usually given a situation where you're in a tempo or a school bus or a car or something like that. So, or you are waiting at a boat club. Somebody comes to inform you about the mishap which has happened on a two-wheeler. So what are the resources available with you all? You have your school van or tempo, whatever. At the boat club, you have the staff, you have the boats, you have first aid kits, and you also have a bike on which the informer has come to inform you. So there are so many resources available. It's very important that we identify these resources. There are lots of hidden resources as well. Ki villages mein kya hoga? Villages mein cattle hoga, tools honge, farmers honge, crowd hoga. Lots of such things. So identify all these resources which will be of use. After that, third para, I used to write information given. So given is time right now is so-and-so. We're 8 members. We also have 2 informers who've come to inform you. We have staff and something like that, information given. After that, I used to write the solution. So in solution, also I used to write in points. So in such cases, when you have to simultaneously take care of so many challenges or problems, you're basically expected to divide the group in certain numbers and then tackle these tasks. So I used to write, initially I'll divide my group in group A, B, C, consisting of 3, 3, and 2 members. Group A will do so and so task, leave from this place at this time, reach their required place at this time, get the task done at this time, and get back to the common meeting point. Group B does this, group C does this. After informing everything, after taking care of all the challenges, everybody regroups at one point and then they together go to the volleyball court to play their match or something like that. So that is how I wrote my solution in parts. Group A does this in so much time, covering so much distance, regroup at this point. Group B does the same, group C does the same, and then regroup. So in these group ABC, I used to also include like the tempo driver or the informers who have come or the villagers or even the police at times is required, or if the rail pattery is damaged, so the railway staff to fix the fish tracks. So all these things. So that is how I used to write my solution. So you're given basically 10 minutes to do the same. And after 10 minutes, the GTO asks you to stop writing and pass on the sheets. And then comes the discussion part. Now, like the screening tests, like the PP and DT, here you're again supposed to discuss with your group members and then come to a common conclusion. Not a conclusion, but a common problem-solving method, right? Everybody would have some different ideas and everything. So now you're supposed to discuss and come to a common solution. Before the discussion starts, the GTO has your sheets, whatever solution you've written. I think writing the solution properly is utmost important, because that is where your individual problem solving skills are seen. Later, how you do it in a group, listening to others' points is a different thing. But how do you do it in a certain 10-minute time? How do you tackle this problem individually on paper is very important. And they have proof, a documented proof of how you solve things or do things. So in this, lots of things matter. कि आप goat को preference दे रहे हो क्या ज़्यादा, बहुत ज़्यादा. ये तीन लोग बस goat को ढूँढने आपने भेज दिए. So it's very important to identify what problem is the most serious and the one to tackle first and things like that. So then the discussion begins. So in my case, what I used to do is I used to initiate. I used to say, okay, friends, I used to start with mentioning all the challenges we have. So friends, all of us must be aware that these are the challenges. These are all the challenges. We are a group of 8 members and these are the resources available. And this is the information given. So I think we should divide our group in group A, B, and C and then tackle these problems one at a time, side by side at the same time. So group A does this, B does. If I'm given a chance to speak, I would give my opinion in such a way. If I'm not given a chance, okay, if somebody else is speaking, I would carefully listen to whatever they're saying. At times it happens that probably while writing, you have missed 2 to 3 things. But when you listen to the discussion which is happening, you get aware, ye point bhi tha. So it is very important that you listen to others, right? It's a group solution. It is not your individual solution jo tum dusro pe thopoge. No. Somebody else might be smarter than you. Somebody else might be having better ideas to solve these problems in sequence in better ways. So it's very important that you listen to others. And if you see that somebody else is giving better points, it is very important that you agree to those points. I used to always do that. Mere se acche agar kisi ne point di hai. So I used to say, friends, I believe he has given a very nice point. I think this should be the approach of solving the problem. So there's... excuse me, there's nothing wrong in that, right? That shows that you're very adaptable, that you're ready to accept that somebody else is better than you, ready to accept their idea. It shows such a good quality. I believe that's a really good quality. But if you're very adamant on your points, ki nahi, meri hi story honi chahiye, mere hi points sahi hai, meri, that goes against you. That will definitely 110% go against you. So I used to do that. If koi agar mere se zyada achhe points de raha hai, toh I used to include, take their points and then move the group towards certain such. It may happen that the group is discussing for 5 minutes on ki kaun se problems hai, kya problem hai, usi mein sara time chale ja raha hai. It happens that. Now your responsibility is to ensure that, I used to say, friends, we've already discussed these challenges. Now let's figure out how to solve these problems. So then I used to ensure that the group goes forward. Now ki kaun se resources are available, ki solution abhi kya karna hai, kaise karna hai, kaise handle kar sakta hai. So it is important that you ensure the group moves forward and not discuss the same thing again and again, 5 to 10 minutes, right? So as if we discuss kar karke, when everyone agrees with each other and y'all are aware ki kya discuss hua hai. When the GTO is aware ki okay, inke discussion se abhi pata chal gaya ki inko idea hai, sab kuch hai. Abhi that the GTO says ki one of y'all nominate amongst yourself, one candidate which will come here and give the entire group solution. So based on my discussion, my points and my cooperation in the group, I was always appointed. Always me, out of say 13 times, 9 to 10 times again, I was appointed by the group to give out the common group narration. So again, it is very important to always be ready. Any chess number from 1 to 8 may be appointed by the group. So somebody may appoint you directly. I believe chess number 4 is very good and he's understood all the points and he or she should give the solution. So in that case, you cannot say, I'm sorry, I am not aware of what has been discussed or I don't know what is discussed or I don't... If that is the case, that goes against you. I did that and it was very wrong on my part, but I did that. Why? Because while things were being discussed, I did not listen to the group very carefully. I was overthinking about my group discussion, which went bad. And I was pressurized and I was in that worry ki, oh no, group discussion to kharab ho gaya. Us tension ki wajah se group planning exercise bhi mera kharab ho gaya. So that is why I was saying ki, do not let your previous test hamper your further test. And also, one mistake I had done in over excitement and over enthusiasm, because mujhe laga ki jo group store, group solution dega, usko sabse jyada points milenge. So in my previous NDE attempt, what I had done is, I was not aware of what was discussed. I was not aware of the group plan. I was not confident. But when the GTO said, acha, who would like to give the group? So I had raised my hand saying, I will give it, sir. Main dunga. But then I gave kuch bakwas sa solution diya. It was so, I did it out of desperation to prove myself that I am good. That went against me, right? So if you're confident, if the group appoints you, be confident and give the group solution. Take your time. And it depends. Usually the GTO says ki you're supposed to brief him or her, the GTO officer. And if you're not appointed, when the group testing officer mentions that, okay, now the group discuss amongst yourself of who you want to appoint. In this case, if you feel that somebody else has been giving more points, is better aware of the entire solution, is better than you, you can appoint him or her as the narrator. That shows a good quality of yours. Ki you are able to identify who's the best in the group. That shows a good quality. That shows ki you are believing in your team member, right? So that is the case. Or at times, I have seen that when we have appointed a certain someone for the group solution, one or the other person may say, ki, no, I don't approve. I don't think he can give it. Somebody else should give it. I think chess number 7 should do. That goes against you because the entire group has believed in certain someone and you're going against the entire group saying, ki, no, I don't believe. Also, do not do that. Believe in your team members. Also, do not let somebody very illogical to be appointed. There are at times... in pressure, certain somebody might give some stupid irrelevant points. So your job is also to ensure that he or she does not get to give out the common group narration. Right? So if you are appointed, say thank you and go forward, give it confidently, give it right. Based on whatever is being discussed, right? Your group solution should be only the things that have been discussed and not what you've written on the paper. Not your story, but the story which has been discussed. And also, at times, if somebody else has given the group narration, the group total solution, the GTO now asks, is there anybody who thinks something else should have been done or there's betterment of solution to that? If that certain someone has given the solution which has been discussed amongst the group, if he or she is given it correct, do not add extra points to that. I think, sir, this should be added or that should be added or this should be done that. Do not. What I did was, one of our friends had given the story in the solution, but he had missed 2 points that instead of going from this route, he had said that we'll go from this route while giving the group solution. So I just pointed out, sir, I think our friend by mistake said that we'll go by this route. But in the group, sir, we discussed that we'll be going by this route. So this is the addition I'd like to suggest. So I pointed out something which was discussed in the group itself and not something out of my own solution or something like that. So stick to whatever the group has discussed. Group discussion ke waqt tumhe jo bhi points dene hai, tum tab hi do. Uske baad kuch points mat do. Right? So I think that is very, very important. And if the one who's giving the group solution so mentions a few wrong points like injured person ko two-wheeler pe leke jayenge when you have a car or something like that. So you can just say, ki, sir, we had discussed so and so. I think it is better that we take the injured person in a car for the safety sake instead of going tripsy on a two-wheeler. So, and you can say these points only if you have already discussed in the group. Do not involve your individual solution or individual points after the group solution is given. That is an approach I used and that always worked for me. I think that's all about group planning exercise. You're all I think this is a test where all your qualities are seen. Whatever I think makes a good leader, a good officer, or whatever it is, whatever OLQs you're aware of, all these things are tested in the group planning exercise. Basically, probably in all the tests, but especially in the group planning exercise. Your coordination, organization skills, your communication with your team members, your leadership quality, your initiative, your confidence, your determination to solve all these problems, your intelligence about identifying all the resources, making good use of all the resources, all these things are tested. And all these things can be taken out of your discussion and your group planning exercise solution. And what else about group planning exercise? I think that's all. I think this session is just for the group discussion and group planning exercise. It's been a long session. So I hope these few things which I used and which were of help of me would help y'all as well. Remember these points because these points are very important. Always remember to be yourself. These are simple instructions given by the GTO that be yourself. Do not put a facade or try to be something else or try to show off your qualities or do something like that. Be yourself and work hard throughout these tests. Work hard does not mean that you give your points always. You, tumhara opinion thopo, ye karo, wo karo. It's not like that. Working hard is when you're given a chance to speak, utilize. When you're somebody else is speaking, listen very carefully. Even that is working hard. It's very important that the communication consists of a lot of things. How you speak, what you speak. Also, how you listen to others. Do you listen to others? Or do you just speak, continue speaking and not give a damn what others are saying? Also, your body language speaks a lot of things about certain someone, a certain person. So, keep your body language very cool and calm. While discussion in GD or GP specifically, because GP may you're supposed to come to a common country. So, do not get aggressive and come out of your chair and do not pat or stop with your hand from somebody who's trying to speak or do something like that. That shows aggression and that shows ki you're not able to be calm and cool in these pressurized situations. So I think these things are important things. Keep these things in mind. All the best. Thank you.